Assalamualaikum. My name is Widi Mutakin from Expose Academy. In this video, we will discuss the UI or the user interface of 3ds Max. And then after that, we will discuss how to navigate the 3D viewports. The first thing that you need to know about 3ds Max UI is that it is customizable. By default, the first time you launch 3ds Max, you will see this UI layout. If for some reason your UI layout is different than mine, then you may need to reset it. This is so we have the same starting point and avoid confusion along the way. To reset the UI layout, you need to go to the workspaces pull-down list up here and then choose Reset to Default State. If you did this and yet your UI still looks different, that is totally fine. But if you still want to reset 3ds Max the hard way, then you can follow these steps. First, close the 3ds Max app. Then, you need to find a folder where all the settings are stored. By default, it is located in your Windows User folder, App Data, Local, Autodesk. Here, you will see a folder named 3ds Max. Just delete the folder, or you can also rename it to any name you like. The next time you start 3ds Max, the 3ds Max folder will be recreated from zero using the default factory settings. I am using 3ds Max version 2021. If you use a different version, there might be some differences in how to do a factory reset. Please check the official documentation for this. At the top, you will find the menu. A menu is probably the most standard UI element across computer applications, whether be in Windows, Linux, or Mac. It usually begins with the File menu and ends with the Help menu. Below the menu, you can find the main toolbar. Inside the main toolbar, you will find most of the common tools when working in 3ds Max. Some of them are the Move tool, Rotate tool, and the Scale tool. You can also find the Material Editor and the Render button here. These groups of buttons on the right side are actually not part of the main toolbar. This is the Project toolbar. And this is the brush presets. For now, we don't need them. So let's discuss how to close them. To show or hide UI elements, you can right-click on these dotted bars. Or you can also right-click on the menu area. This will open up the UI elements list. The ones that have checkboxes are the ones that are currently open or visible. If you have plugins installed, you may find additional items here. For example, I have the Corona rendering plugin installed. Therefore, you can see the Corona official toolbar in this list. To close the project toolbar, for example, simply click on the project list item here. And let's close the brush presets also. Below the main toolbar, you will find the ribbon. The ribbon is a special panel where you can find a lot of polygon modeling tools. But these tools are hidden unless you have an editable poly object selected. We are not going to cover modeling yet in this video, so we can safely close it for now. To do that, you can use the previous right-click method. You can see the ribbon option here. But the easier way to do this is by clicking this button in the main toolbar. This is basically a toggle button, so you can click it again if you ever need to show the ribbon back. Next, on the left side, you will find the viewport layout tab, which is in my opinion not really useful and it is taking too much of the screen space. But before we close it, I'm going to show you what this panel actually does. This panel is used to change the viewport layout. For example, we can click on this caret button and click on this layout. We now have a different viewport layout. Most of the time, we will be using the maximize-minimize viewport toggle technique. Rarely do we need to switch the viewport layout back and forth. So, just set this to the standard quad layout, and then close the panel by right-clicking here, and choose Viewport Layout tab. Next is the Scene Explorer. This panel is useful to list and organize the objects in the scene. In theory, you can show and hide the Scene Explorer by clicking this button up here in the main toolbar. But if you click on it, 3ds Max will open another Scene Explorer. So now we have two Scene Explorers. If you click this button again, it will close the second Scene Explorer and does not affect the first one. Personally, I prefer to use this one as I can show and hide it easily using this button. Let's just close the first one. Right-click on the menu area. We can see we have two Scene Explorer panels listed here. We want to close the default one, so click on it. Then, you can drag this one to the left area, like so. Or, let me float this panel back. Another way to dock the panel is by right-clicking on the title bar, and then choose dock, and then left. Either way, we have the Scene Explorer docked to the left area. And because it is not the default Scene Explorer, we can quickly show and hide it using this button up here in the main toolbar. Next, the large area at the center is the viewport. You can think of it like a window where you can see your 3D world from different angles. By default, we have 4 viewports. If we look closely at each of these viewports, we can see the name of the viewport labeled at the top left corner. This is the top viewport where we are looking from the top direction. This is the front viewport, which is basically looking at the front side. And this one is the left viewport. And finally, the last one, which looks a bit different from the rest, is the perspective viewport. We can maximize a viewport by pressing Alt-W. But first, you need to move your mouse cursor to the viewport that you want to maximize. For example, if you move your mouse cursor on top of the perspective viewport, then hit Alt-W, the perspective viewport will be maximized. You can press Alt-W again to minimize it back. If you move your mouse cursor on this front viewport area, and then press Alt-W, then we get the front viewport maximized. Besides using Alt-W shortcut, you can also use this button at the bottom right corner to maximize or minimize a viewport. But for this to work on the viewport that you want, you need to activate the viewport first by right-clicking on it. An active viewport is indicated by this thick border. Now if you click this button, that active viewport will be maximized. Down here, you can find the timeline, but in 3ds Max, we call it the time slider. Essentially, the time slider is used for things related to animation, such as scrubbing the time, placing keyframes, etc. Next, down here, you will find the Max Script Console, Status, Transformation Values, Keyframe Tools, Playback Tools, and this area at the far right is for viewport navigation. Next, on the right side of the screen, you will find the Command Panel. This is probably the second most important UI element in 3ds Max after the main toolbar. So, you never want to close this one. The Command Panel is divided into several sub-panels or tabs. First is the Create Panel. This is where you can create new objects inside 3ds Max. The second sub-panel is the Modify Panel. This is where you go when you need to modify existing objects. Then the Hierarchy Panel, where you can set up pivot points, linking, rigging, etc. The Motion Panel, where you can set up and manage animations. The Display Panel, where you can control how 3ds Max displays objects. And the last one is the Utilities Panel, where you can find some helpful features in different categories. To learn viewport navigation, first, we will need some objects in the scene. I am creating some teapots now and a plane object. I know we haven't discussed object creation yet, but this is not the point of this lesson, so just bear with me for now. Alright, to navigate the viewports in 3ds Max, we can actually use several methods. The first method is by using the mouse. The second method is using the Viewcube. The third method is using the steering wheel. And the last method is by using the UI buttons. In this video, we will only cover the first method, which is using the mouse. This is by far the fastest method to navigate around the viewports. You should always pick this method as your first priority. Now, before we begin, for this method to work, you will need a standard mouse with a scroll wheel or a middle button. You don't want to rely on your laptop's trackpad for working inside 3ds Max. And if you want to purchase a mouse, please be aware that some mouse products don't have any scroll wheel or middle button. This kind of mouse will not help you at all if you are serious in using 3ds Max or learning any 3D applications in general. Let's begin with panning the viewport. To pan the viewport, you can use the middle mouse button. Now, some people just don't realize that they have a middle mouse button, because it is actually part of the scroll wheel. So, if you press down on a scroll wheel, you are actually pressing on the middle mouse button. Again, you need to press it down, not scrolling it around. After you press and hold it, if you move the mouse, the viewport will pan around. Now, you need to understand that we are now doing navigation, not transformation. Meaning, these 3D objects do not move at all. It is how we see the objects that is moving. Alright. To zoom in and out of the viewport, we can rotate the scroll wheel back and forth, scroll forward to zoom in, and scroll backward to zoom out. Another method to zoom, but with more precision, is by holding the control and the alt keys together, and then click and drag with the middle mouse button back and forth. With this method, the zoom motion will be smooth, not in steps as before. Finally, to rotate or orbit the viewport, you need to hold the alt key and then press the middle mouse button, and just move the mouse around. As you can see, the viewport will rotate. Now, for this last method, you should only perform this on the perspective viewport. Why? Well, because if you do this on the other viewports, for example, the left viewport, the viewport will change into an orthographic viewport. This orthographic viewport is almost like the perspective viewport. But notice, it doesn't have any vanishing points. To switch the viewport back to the left view, or any views that you want, you can click on this text, which is the second label menu, and choose the viewport type from the list here. We can also see here that the left view shortcut is L, front view is F, and so on. Currently, we want to revert this viewport back to the left view. This cube-like UI element at the top right corner of the viewport is called the Viewcube. You can use this to navigate the viewport. But since we are going to use the mouse for navigation, let's hide them for now. To do this, you can press Ctrl+Alt+V. Or, if you forget the shortcut, you can just click on the plus sign menu up here, choose Viewcube, and then click on this Show the Viewcube option. Now, all of the view cubes are hidden. If you are new to 3ds Max, or even never used 3D software before, and you want to start learning and mastering 3D modeling using 3ds Max in the quickest way possible, you definitely need to take this course. You will be guided to model all these 3D objects from start to finish, while at the same time learn important concepts in 3D graphics step by step along the way. There are more than 9 hours of quality educational content in this course. So join the course now through the link I provided below. As always, subscribe to my channel, share the video, give a thumbs up if you like the video, and give a thumbs down if you hate the video. Please check out the next part of this tutorial or any other tutorials on my channel. Wassalamualaikum.